named Stir the Kid versus
Red X.
Red X. Oh yes, we heard about Red X.
I think he's going by Red now, though. I believe used to go by Era 404 in the beginning of Ultimate. Pretty much everyone in existence told him that was a bad name, so he went back to Red. And thank God he did. He's always been playing Ike. Was an Ike main back in the Smash 4 days. Bring him right back to it.
And of course, Stir the Kid, another Smash 4 veteran, played the NES and the Lucas, but he's been playing NES mainly in the Ultimate. And he's one of those players that it feels like the transition of the game just helped him level up. Like, his results are noticeably better. He was never like a bad player by any means.
No.
He would top 8 locals all the time. Maybe not Xenos, but like a lot of other locals. But in Ultimate, just I think the overall pace of the game has made it where his results have just like by like a consistently like 3 or 4 placings, you know?
Yeah.
And as we're seeing right there, getting a back throw for that first stock, Stern looking pretty good.
Yeah, taking away that first stock. You saw Red trying to search for these neutral airs. Obviously, that's like the number one thing that Ike wants. He gets so much off of Nair. You know, he gets kills off of them. Trying to wait for bait out that air dodge. Good DI coming from Stir to avoid said follow-up. Now, Red has been a player that I feel like has been struggling a bit to find his way around the bracket and trying to get some results, because like he's not like getting top 8, like we were saying previously, but I know he has the potential to get up there. So just a little bit more practice, a little bit more matches. Let's see what he can do, you know, what he's gonna do against Stir. They both have something to prove. Okay, 133%. Looking for a potential edge guard. Trying to set him up with the down tilt. Opts to go for the neutral air instead.
Ooh. Okay, there it is. Great job with that ledge trapping. The neutral air finally confirming.
Yeah, great option select, honestly.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the neutral air, the thing about it is it just covers options. I know it looks, sometimes it looks like, oh, he's just spamming it. It's like actually a good Ike is calculating the fact that, okay, this is limiting these options, and then I just have to prepare for the few that remain.
Yeah.
Or, you know, my opponent just runs into the nair. Yippee.
Yeah, he just covered ledge and all that jazz. Okay, here we go.
Oh! No! Ness up air.
Back throw is going to send him. Not okay, maybe he's a lighter character.
That move also got nerfed.
Yeah. Still strong. Very,
oh,
very,
yeah.
Very strong move. There we go. Go for the neutral air, add a shield just to get him off me.
Barely avoiding that forward air. And the up smash to take it out. You don't often see that move kill, but there it is. And now, Stir, one thing that he's been doing to combat these neutral airs, you notice instant aerials. It's Ike can't really do instant neutral air. It has to be delayed. It has to be landing. And that means that especially a character like Ness, who has fast aerials with some decent range in front of him, he's just looking to intercept it. But intercepted. Oh,
he wasn't brave enough. I know Red was thinking about trying to do something against that, like a down air, or I think he just got like cold feet at the last second, ended up paying the ultimate price, because if he didn't even want to like collide with him whatsoever, he could just easily roll on stage. Let's watch that again, right? So he goes for the LP, get on that ledge. Now right here, he let go of that ledge because he was trying to like do something, maybe like a back air, maybe a down air or something. Like another counter is an option, but he just kind of messed up the timing, and then he didn't want to commit, and then because he regrabbed the ledge, having no invincibility whatsoever, PK Thunder got the kill. Because he could have avoided that entire situation just by getting on stage.
Yeah. Shoutouts to Dharamgarya with the A sub right there. I believe I pronounced the name correctly.
Hey, thank you. We appreciate you.
Oh, we appreciate all of them. But the people who sub, we appreciate them just a little bit more.
Wow. No, I don't listen to him. I appreciate every single one of you in the viewership.
Oh, no, I appreciate every one of them, too. But, like,
wow, you're
literally
ranking them.
Love.
So
I'm just trying
you're one of those parents
it.
That, like, have to make a power ranking for their children, aren't you? I know you are.
It's the PR.
It's a PR for your children.
Yeah.
I know you do it. You have your favorite. Anyways, game two. Battlefield.
What do you think of this stage counter pick?
Got the stage counter pick coming out from Ike. Obviously, he's a swordy. He's got triplats. All swordies in this game love triplats. Allows them to be able to use their big-ass sword, cut through them on the platforms. They'll be able to. It's a very small stage as well, so allows them to be able to just go through the entire, they'll be able to go out through the entire stage and just, you know, limit the options. It's a very small stage for them to, like, try to, like, fight them in, you know? So, yeah.
So far, though, Stir's been doing a really good job of just positioning himself around the platforms, spacing outside of Ike's range just like that, because if you force the guy to whiff, that's... Oh! Okay, I thought that was actually going to land.
Mm-hmm.
Woo! Cute.
There you go. Just crosses him over with the back air. I love this pressure he's doing against this shield. Needs to rock it right now. He's got stage advantage.
One more neutral air might kill him. I have a feeling it would.
I'm not sure if he wanted to go for dash attack right there. There we go.
I love the little wave dash to actually get behind him. Interesting way to cross up. I guess I didn't realize that, yeah, you can air dodge through people. So if you want to get behind a character. But that's the neutral air that we were talking about. And Stern right now struggling to get these kills. And Ike is a character who just thrives so much. Finally up air connecting. But that was a lot of momentum that Stir lost just by taking, like, if you think about the amount of hits that they received, it wasn't equivalent, but the damage wasn't what matters. It matters, you know, who managed to actually take the stop.
These combos are starting to look a little sick from Stir. I see those little cancels. I mean, I respect him going off that deep with a forward air, just trying to call out that side B, because he would have been dead. They're just going to slap around. Gives him some breathing room with that up air to get back onto the stage safe and sound. Connects another PK fire, which is going to be able to double jump out of that situation.
I'm actually loving the movement from Stir. And Ness's jumps, like the momentum of it can be so awkward. And he's just using that to his advantage, almost like float canceling, sort of. The way that he, like, positions himself between everything. And that back throw should do it. We now have a 2-1 lead. Let's see whether Red can make this comeback. I mean, he is on a big stage like Battlefield. Ike hits hard enough where if he just picks his right opportunities and doesn't get comboed to 80. Ooh. Okay, only got comboed to 50. Not that bad.
Okay, good evasion right there. Just jumping over the yo-yo once more. At this point, you'll notice that Ness is applying a lot of pressure from underneath the platform, trying to keep Red from being able to find any sort of stage control. And try to get that yo-yo out just in time. There we go. Follows up with the dash attack. Has him off stage. If Red's going to go for a kill, he needs it now. Ooh. There's the counter he's been trying to do the whole time. Counter very a destructive option against the PK kids.
Against any character with like a consistent hitbox. But against them specifically because of how strong that hitbox is supposed to be. Ooh. Still continuing this juggle. Continuing the damage.
There. Red looking a little scared. Trying to figure out his way around this PK Thunder. Has him off stage. Wait a minute. Capitalize. Too early, too far to the right.
I don't think he's invincibility.
Okay, he's going to be able to forward it right through that yo-yo.
Dude, what's going on off stage?
He's trying to catch him with the up B because if he manages to catch Ness with that, he could easily kill him. No. Forward's back on stage. The sword pressure's coming back. Has him off stage again. Side B. Gets clipped by the tail of PK Thunder, thus getting him out of like the any sort of lag that he would have had. Okay, gonna respect it this time around.
Wow, just safe. Going up in his face. One more neutral air is probably going to do it from either player, but the Ike neutral air is what's a lot scarier. Actually, that neutral air from Stir not being able to take it. Goes charges up the down smash, doesn't work, but the grab ends up connecting, and there we have game two. Yeah, that was game two. Stir
that is the set, yes. So Stir actually dragged him with the yo-yo right in front of him for him to be able to get that grab right afterwards. Right there. It was kind of a wonky little hitbox there. I'm pretty sure Red didn't know what was going on because he was just standing there holding shield until he's like, wait, I'm in front of him. It was a little bit too late. Got the grab, got the back throw, and that's all she wrote. So Stir taking out Red 2-0, gonna move on to the bracket.